He's a great guy.
Today, I am in Calgary, Alberta, and I have an absolute treat for you guys today. Arguably, one of my favorite fish rooms and or, I guess, fish garage that I've ever visited. I'm here.
They're here somewhere.
There it is. Marshall.
Yeah, we just
and Stacy.
Hi.
This is... Well, why don't you tell me what this is? Because I think you kind of designed it at first. It used to be a workshop or something?
Yeah, it used to be a granite shop over here. And then this was just the fish room. And yeah, it's just...
evolved into this. Just absolutely
it escalated.
Really, and then Marshall
hard.
Got his hands on it.
Yeah.
And he came out and decided to do... This is your guys' fish house together.
Yep.
Fish garage.
Yeah.
Why don't you give us a quick tour? And well, first let's introduce ourselves.
I'm Stacy.
Yeah. Marshall.
Yeah.
All right. Who wants to lead the way? How about we do 50-50? Marshall, you do this half. And Stacy, do you want to do this half?
Yeah. Sure.
Okay. Marshall, you lead the way.
All right. Multiple fish, all different kinds, but breed and take care of.
Yeah.
Mostly breeders and stuff in here. Yeah.
Why don't you go tank by tank? Because there's a lot in here. You look like you're into the African cichlids for sure.
Yeah.
A little loud in here, so we might have to talk a little extra loud. It looks... Oh, you're breeding the flower horns too?
There's tons of babies in there already.
Yeah, I can see them. Wow.
We have a stepfather on the last side. He likes to take care of them also.
This is the stepfather?
Yeah, he doesn't eat the babies.
He doesn't eat them? Just takes care of
is
them.
Is the stepdad? Where's the mom?
She should be in there unless he killed her.
Oh, she's in the back.
She might be dead.
She just said, put her in the back there. I can see her silhouette.
Yeah.
That's cool. The stepdad. Oh, man.
Yeah, mostly just cichlids on this side right here.
Yeah. There's so much going on. How are all these filtered? Sponges?
The DIY way?
Yeah.
Yeah, of course.
With the peanut butter jars? With air
peanut butter jar, air filter, nice.
Yeah.
Both those? What's this?
Not sure.
Succulents of some sort.
Yeah.
Succulents.
It does well in here.
It does well, so I just keep letting it go.
What size are these tanks? 30?
20s?
20s?
Yeah.
Okay.
We wanted to do the men filters also on them, but that's like down the road. We'll do that, right? But for now,
looks need more air taps and stuff.
Yeah.
What's this pipe here? Water changers?
That's just drain to the sump.
Oh.
Yeah, and the sump goes all the way around the interconnected.
Yeah.
All of them are connected to the sump?
This whole stand is one system.
Okay.
And then this whole stand is one system.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Comes in, you got pot scrubbies, metallic mat. Nice. And over here it looks like lava rock.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Perfect. All your fish are breeding. Yeah. This is convicts. Oh, you're creating some sort of convict over here, you mentioned earlier.
This one, yeah, I'm hoping to make this one.
What are you going
to
do?
I'm hoping to get the platinum parrots more shaped like him.
Oh,
so
definitely.
It doesn't look like a parrot.
Okay.
No, it looks like more like a parrot. I'm trying to get more body shape like him.
Right.
With a black and white instead of the blue. And I call it the white tiger.
Ooh, the white tiger.
Yeah.
Mike Tyson's going to want it.
Yeah.
What size tank is this? This is huge.
340, I think it is.
340?
Yeah.
That's a pretty cool tank as well. What is your guys' purpose with all of this? Obviously, you love keeping fish, but you're breeding, kind of trying to provide the hobby with some more sources of fish.
Yeah, quality fish.
And a fish rescue.
High-end fish rescue, and, you know, house special fish that most people shouldn't be housing. You got bigger tanks.
Yeah.
And if I can convince them, a brand new YouTube channel, but we'll see. One thing at a time. If they do it, links in the description. I'll let you know at the end of the video. These guys got so much to show you, so much to talk about. And we'll try to get through it as quickly as possible. Marshall, what do we got going over here?
Some more Africans. Green terriers up here. There's fairy cichlids in that one.
Fairy cichlids?
Yeah, in the top tank. In the back corner.
Yeah, you can't really see
them.
In
the very corner there.
Yeah.
A school of them. Sword tails.
And this is a succulent. I've never seen people do the nutrient export with a succulent. The pothos, yes, but never this. And this is healthy.
Yeah, it works really well in there.
Mm.
Not sure of the name. And then, some more Africans. Parrotfish.
Oh, here he goes. Those guys are always nice. the parrots did you breed or did you bring them
Those were brought in.
Okay.
Yeah. These ones were bred here though.
Fleischer.
Gourami.
Those rainbows, eh?
They're beautiful.
Yeah, neon rainbows.
And getting close enough to that brush reflection.
These ones I bred. These are third generation.
Okay.
Yeah.
This guy's super mean.
Yeah, this is the meanest fish in the fish room.
Better be careful.
Oh yeah.
Jesus. Crazy as he water in the tank.
Yeah, he's crazy.
Yeah, he's a crazy one.
Oh! He doesn't even care. He's like, do it again. Yeah. Do it again. You want it?
That's my tank.
Yeah. This is clearly. Well, it looks like some form of a
flower horn.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Man, camphor of some sort.
It's a female, but it's not. No. It just doesn't have a huge bump, right?
Well, and well, I can't see its vent very well, but maybe I can tell.
Like it, I just want to bite you.
Come on up here so I can see your belly. I'd say it's male. No, well, I can't really tell. I'd have to take it out, look at its look underneath. You want to do it? I can tell you what it is.
Oh my God.
That's whether it's male or female.
Yeah. If you want to stick your hand in there.
I've never seen somebody so nervous about their own fish.
Yeah. No, I don't stick my hand in there. That's what these poles are for. I had a little scrubby brush here too, and that's
only that I just. You gotta distract them with the one thing, and then clean the tank with the other.
Yeah.
Okay. You explained this to me earlier, but what is this?
It's a rocket mass stove.
Rocket man?
Rocket mass.
Rocket mass.
Yeah, okay. Rocket mass heater is what it is. That's how I heat the garage.
How's it work?
I burn wood in here, and then it goes down and through a bench that I heat the bench with the wood on the other side, and that heats the whole room.
It's like third world country.
Oh, is that what that is?
Technology,
it's like
yeah.
Very old technology?
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
That is super cool, though. Yeah. Oh, I think we skipped right by these guys. Oh, beautiful. Oscar's here. This is a beautiful tiger. Is he a bumblebee? It's so dark. He's gorgeous. Gourami. Wow, true parrot. Is that a lungfish?
Yep.
Damn, I didn't see him earlier.
There's a wolffish in there too. He's pretty awesome. He fast though.
He's what?
He's fast. Eats anything small that goes in there. Right there.
Yeah, he's on the bottom. Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah. This one's great because you can throw all of our like veggies and stuff in there. And they eat it all. Lettuce, strawberries, celery, anything. The gouramis and even the big catfish will eat everything that you put in. Apples.
Chops. The ripsaw catfish, yeah.
He he's a chunky monkey.
Yeah.
I gotta say, all your fish look like they just ate.
Yeah.
Very healthy looking. Did they just eat before I came?
Nope.
No,
okay. I actually left them hungry so they're more spunky.
This is a ridiculously sized tank. How many gallons is this?
I think it'll be 800 when it's full.
800?
Yeah.
Damn, it looks bigger than that, because I got that 700. Wait, how long is this? 10
12 feet?
12?
12.
And 4?
4. 12 by 4 by 30.
This is more than 800 gallons.
Okay. I haven't done the math on it, so I'm
I'm using my phone to do this, because I didn't bring my proper camera.
Yeah.
But, yeah, I'll do the math here in a little bit. I'll post the real number up on the screen here, but
I just say that I like to be conservative.
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 Well, yeah, because if you say it's like a this is an 8,000 gallon tank, and I'm like, it's probably closer to 1,200.
Yeah.
Shoot lower expectations.
Yeah. Same with the size of the fishes and stuff too. I like to be smaller.
These little short body convicts always crack me up.
Those are bred here too.
Were they?
Yep.
That's the biggest we've actually seen them get.
That's the biggest you've seen them get?
These guys, the males, there's...
Oh yeah, I've seen them about this size before.
Yeah.
Really cool as albinos. And even the smaller they are, the better.
Yeah.
Interesting that they're still a convict though. They're not crossed with anything, are they? Are they just selectively bred?
Selectively bred, yeah.
What else we got here?
Midas.
Yeah.
Some more breeding Midas.
They're breeding? Damn. What is your,
Midas is something we can't get rid of.
That's kind of cool. It looks like there's smoke in there, but that's filter floss.
Yeah, it's just filter floss. It was an experimental mat I tried to use for a matting filter.
Okay.
And it didn't work, and it disintegrated into that.
great.
So now it's just biological media.
Yeah, they love it. Yeah, what do you think is, like, if you had one tip or one, like, little piece of secret information to give people when breeding fish, what would you say that would be?
Clean, fresh water.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yep. Clean, fresh water. Yep.
Perfect. You ready to do your half?
Yeah.
Okay, you guys are going to love this side, too. It just gets crazier and crazier in here.
Yeah, no, a lot of this side is rescues, right? So, the goldfish, all rescues, the piranhas are rescues, everything pretty much, other than these tanks. I was trying to get
Kissing
fish to breed in there. I don't even think they're alive still.
Well, these guys are breeding too.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. And then this was actually our biggest tank that we started with.
This was it?
Yeah.
That was our big tank.
Yeah, we got these two tanks and we were like, ooh, look at us.
Look at our big tank.
And then we got this one. This one was actually easier to move than this one. So it was, because bringing this in, but.
Oh, and all that heat comes out of that bench over there you're talking about?
Yeah.
The bench for the rocket mass heater.
Yeah.
So we keep that fire going to keep that hot in the winter. And circulates
the air. Yeah, it goes right into the greenhouse.
So you have stingrays in this one.
Yeah.
And more angelfish, like severums, silver dollars. Wow.
This was our brackish attempt.
And then a crazy blacked out tank with tilapia in it.
Tilapia, yeah.
And this feeds your greenhouse?
Yep.
And these guys do too.
Yep.
So this is what I'm used to seeing when people do greenhouses with tilapia, is relatively small tanks in comparison to the size of the fish and the number of them, but for the most part they pack them in to be able to grow all of this. You got to take us through that. That is incredible out there.
Yeah, well, we just got rid of everything, but we had cucumbers and tomatoes, and we have this is our holding tank for the winter. Like, it's got koi and bigger fish in there with the turtles, and the turtles.
Oh, I didn't see these guys.
Yeah, there's actually more than there should be in there. There's six in there, but we have the pond on the ground to split them up that we dug into the ground. So some of them go in there, and they've actually laid eggs. Like right here.
On the way.
Yep.
So now all of this is connected
just to here.
Yeah. Nice. Mm-hmm. And it's incredibly successful. One thing that I think is going to blow a lot of people's mind is, you want to tell us what that plant is?
It's a pothos.
Yeah, pothos. Yeah. Look at the size of the stem on there. And you can literally trace it back. I seen this in Mexico. I even said it on the video, but I never realized how big pothos got. And they get even bigger than this. I got to say, out of everything here, your greenhouse is definitely inspiring, and I want to do it, especially since you were talking about winter time, because we are in Canada.
Yeah.
How are you guys dealing with all that cold?
Oh,
lots of chopping wood.
Yeah, we chop a lot of wood.
You just simply heat it.
Yeah. Yeah, and we sit about 25 to 30 all winter.
25 to 30 all winter.
Yeah, so it's like our own little paradise.
Wow.
Yeah, our own winter paradise.
Yeah.
I gotta do a greenhouse. That's super cool. I'd love to do that. Get my hands on. I'll just copy you guys.
Yeah.
That's fine. We'll help you.
They only have a ton of tanks in their house. We won't cover those today. We're gonna let them do that on their own channel and bring you guys through this in a more in-depth thing. Maybe you guys want a closer look at the fish, or to talk about how this was done or that was done, or simply just some basic information. I think that this is an absolutely amazing starter point for a lot of people in the hobby, beginner, intermediate, as well as expert, to just come and enjoy this place. I'm in love with it. I was telling them earlier that I would trade the gallery for this place. And they, the looks on their face, I was like, no, this is way cooler and there's way more things going on. And it seems like way more tinkering, and it's way more up to what, you know, how I got in the hobby and whatnot. But this weekend I am here speaking at their aquarium club, the Calgary Aquarium Society. If you don't know who they are, I'll also leave a link in the description below. I believe you guys are the treasurers of the club?
Yeah.
Or the librarians?
Librarians.
Right. So I'll leave a link in the description for them as well. If you're in the Calgary area and you want to become part of something just a little bit more within your hobby, check them out. But more importantly, I'm leaving a link to their channel in the description below. I don't know the name of it because they haven't created it yet, but it's going to be created by the time this comes out, because the world needs to see more of these guys' crazy
fish garage. What do you call it? The
something fun.
Garage.
The garage.
The garage. She says it here with me.
The correct way. Okay.
The correct way. All right, guys.
Do me a favor, go ahead and just shower them with love, subscribe to their channel, support them. It is very intimidating and different to start a channel, especially when you don't know what you're doing. My community is incredibly supportive, and you guys have been around for a long time, so I know you'll be not only supportive of them, but also encouraging and kind of help them along the ways. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. I'll see you guys in the next one.